In today's show, Bitcoin price eyes all-time high weekly close above $60,000 ahead of Bitcoin's ETF turbulence. That's right, Bitcoin is on track to have its highest weekly close in Bitcoin history. In today's show, I'll be breaking down the latest technical analysis, as well as the latest updates from crypto analysts, Rec Capital, and Pentoshi. Also in today's show, Salvadorans are now selling way more US dollars to buy Bitcoin, as their president, Nayib Bukele, shares here. He also says today we received over 24,000 remittances, adding up to over $3 million. In a single day, and it's the Lightning Network that makes this all possible. And as Lynn Alden points out, Lightning Network capacity has roughly tripled from 1K to 3,000 BTC year to date. Check out this graph, the numbers don't lie. Also in today's show, breaking news, Grayscale plans to file for a spot Bitcoin ETF early next week, according to sources from CNBC. That's right, Grayscale's official filing will kick off a 75-day review period for the SEC to either approve or deny the spot Bitcoin ETF, a first of its kind, physically set Bitcoin financial product. That's right, and unlike the futures-backed Bitcoin ETF, which just got the green light from the SEC to be launched on Monday or Tuesday of this week. Also in today's show, Bitcoin is entering the final stage of a major bull trend, according to this crypto analyst who sees Bitcoin surpassing $100,000 in the next few months. We'll also be taking a look at the latest updates from crypto analyst TechDev, who reminds us if history repeats, we can see a 900% increase here in the fourth quarter of 2021, taking us to $370,000 per BTC. He also mentions here $200,000 to $300,000 Bitcoin looks almost to program. We'll also be taking a look at the overall crypto market. As you can see, Bitcoin and Ether, many of the alts are currently correcting and in the red. But where's the Bitcoin price likely to go next? Find out all this, plus so much more in today's show. Here at Crypto News Alerts, I drop a brand new episode every single day. The goal is to get to 50,000 subs. If you like earning money in cryptocurrency, be sure to smash that subscribe button and ring that bell to turn on all notifications to receive daily premium crypto news alerts every single day, including weekends, just like this. If you're planning on buying tokens on the Ethereum, Polygon, or Binance Smart Chain, you should really consider doing so on the 1-inch decentralized exchange aggregator. As we all know, decentralized exchanges are great, but aggregators like 1-inch are even better. That's because they automatically find you the lowest price, along with the lowest slippage and the best exchange rates across a multitude of different DEXs. And as you can see, transaction costs are up to 42% cheaper on 1-inch, which is very nice. And additionally, they also rolled out a program where they're giving the gas fees back to users up to 10 million 1-inch tokens worth, which is currently ongoing as of September 1st. And to check out how much is needed to stake and how much you can earn back, check it out right here. Staking of 100 1-inch allows users to get a 25% gas refund, while staking of 100,000 1-inch allows users to get a 100% gas refund. And another additional feature that they have rolled out is their referral program, which many DEXs have not yet implemented, as well as a mobile app for iOS users, so you can do some decentralized trading on the go. To take advantage of 1-inch, the most efficient DeFi aggregator, go ahead and click the link in the description right down below, and let's start stacking those sats, shall we? All right, welcome back to another episode of Crypto News Alerts. I'm your host, JV. How's it going, crypto fam? Holla at your boy in the live chat. Bitcoin faces a pivotal weekly close on October 17th, with the bull scrambling to squash final resistance before hitting new all-time highs. That's right, we're on track to have the highest weekly close in Bitcoin history. Let's go, BTC. Data from Cointelegraph Markets Pro and TradingView showed Bitcoin ranging throughout the weekend, crucially staying above $60,000. This week's close was already tipped to be a deal breaker, potentially being its highest ever. Only once before has Bitcoin ended a weekly candle above the $60,000 mark. With only hours left to go, analysts were bracing for a potentially pivotal moment, one that could open up the path for uncharted territory for the bulls. That's right, how many of you feel that Bitcoin will enter price discovery mode here this week? Holla at your boy in the live chat, especially with the Bitcoin futures back ETF, which was just greenlit by the SEC. And quoting crypto analyst Rec Capital here on crypto Twitter, another Bitcoin daily close above the red area later today, and Bitcoin will have confirmed a break beyond its final major resistance on the weekly time frame, and that's at about that $52,000 mark, as you can see right here in this chart. And for fellow trader Pentoshi, he added that Bitcoin has now retouched its all-time high market cap on the daily time frame, further reinforcing the importance of the current trading range, as he shares here on crypto Twitter. Market cap touch all-time high close in the last candle seems important. Now let's discuss some Bitcoin ETFs. Monday constitutes the earliest conceivable launch day for the first approved United States Bitcoin exchange traded long-awaited fund product. With Bitcoin climbing as rumors of a long-awaited go-ahead hit late last week, concerns that the episode will turn into the buy the rumor, sell the news event remain. This could provide for volatile trading conditions. And as shared in this poll on crypto Twitter, the approval of a Bitcoin ETF by the SEC is the classic buy the rumor, sell the fact event. And 55.7% said yes, and 44.3% said no. Let me know your thoughts in the comments right down below. And checking out Max Kaiser's response to a futures-backed Bitcoin ETF being approved, there's a whole gaggle of Bitcoin ETFs coming to market all over the world. The futures contract one people are talking about today is an equally crappy product like all futures-based ETFs. Net-net, it's not important to the rise of Bitcoin and the collapse of fiat. That's right, and before I break down next story of the day, Salvadorans are now selling way more US dollars to buy Bitcoin, as well as breaking news, Grayscale Investments plans to file for a spot Bitcoin ETF early next week, as well as Bitcoin is entering the final stage of a major bull trend, according to this crypto analyst who foresees Bitcoin surpassing $100,000 in the next few months, as well as the latest technical analysis and Bitcoin price predictions from crypto analyst TechDev. But first, let's take a quick look at the overall crypto market. As you can see, Bitcoin barely in the red, currently correcting down 0.03%, but still trading above $60,800. Ethereum down 1.5%, trading just above $3,800. Solana, one of the few actually in the green, up 3.5%, trading at $165, while Polkadot, Binance Coin, Cardano, XRP, and Chainlink all currently correcting and in the red. But all right, now let's break down our next story of the day. El Salvador's mainstream Bitcoin adoption is gaining momentum during the ongoing bull run as citizens are increasingly exchanging their US dollar savings for BTC. Also like to point out, they're all in profit. Let's go. President Nayib Bukele shared in this new development on Twitter, based on data acquired from El Salvador's in-house wallet service, Chivo. Bukele shared the following on crypto Twitter, two new Chivo facts. Number one, people are inserting way more USD to buy Bitcoin than what they are withdrawing from the Chivo ATMs. And any media outlet can independently confirm this by visiting the ATMs. And number two, today we received 24,076 remittances, adding up to over $3 million in one day. Now, the increase in dollar to Bitcoin conversions within the jurisdiction reflects a change in investor sentiment, which initially faced resistance during adoption from the general public. Moreover, the Salvadoran government offers various subsidies for using Bitcoin, such as fuel subsidies and tax exemptions. I think that is pretty cool to help usher in Bitcoin adoption, incentivizing people to use their BTC. However, the greatest incentive of all is hodling and watching those numbers go up. Just saying, El Salvador has installed over 200 ATMs after adopting Bitcoin as a legal tender, making it the third largest network of crypto ATMs after the United States and Canada. And as Cointelegraph reported, El Salvador exceeded United Kingdom's crypto ATM count after deploying 205 crypto ATMs, mainly to facilitate local Bitcoin transactions and Bitcoin to dollar conversions. I also like to point out, they're charging no fees on those ATMs installed in El Salvador. So kudos to Nayib Bukele. And recently, the Salvadoran government announced it will build a $4 million veterinary hospital using the profits attained during the Bitcoin bull market. And according to President Bukele, the veterinary hospital will host 4 operating rooms, 4 emergency clinics, 19 offices, as well as a rehabilitation area. We decided to invest a part of that money in this, a veterinary hospital for our furry friends. So there you have it. And before I break down our next breaking story of the day, Grayscale Investments plans to file for a spot Bitcoin ETF early this week, according to sources from CNBC, as well as Bitcoin is entering the final stage of a major bull trend, according to this crypto analyst who foresees Bitcoin surpassing $100,000 in the next few months, as well as Bitcoin potentially surging 900% here in Q4, taking us to $370,000 per BTC. But first, let's take a quick look at the overall crypto market cap, sitting just under that $2.5 trillion milestone with $83 billion in volume in the past 24 hours. Current Bitcoin dominance is 46.3%, with the Ether dominance at 18.4%. And checking out the top gainers within the top 100, we have Phantom leading the pack, up almost 11%, trading at $2.24. Quant up 6.5%, trading at $314. And Stacks up 4.4%, trading at $2.09. Now, which altcoins are you currently most bullish on during Q4? Let me know in the comments right down below. And now checking out one of my favorite indicators is the Crypto Greed and Fear Index. Shows we're currently rated a 79 out of 100 in extreme greed. Yesterday was a 78, last week a 71, and last month a 48 in neutral. And if you're not familiar with the Crypto Greed and Fear Index, extreme fear can be a sign investors are too worried. That could be a great buying opportunity, aka BTFD, buy that freaking dip. And when investors are getting too greedy, that means the market is due for a correction. All right, now let's break down our next story of the day. We could have the first spot Bitcoin ETF on the market near the end of this year, as Grayscale intends to file for the SEC approval for its product by early next week, according to sources from CNBC. The official Grayscale filing will kick off a 75-day review period from the SEC to either approve or deny the proposed spot Bitcoin ETF, a first of its kind physically settled Bitcoin financial product. And after the approval of a Bitcoin futures ETF by companies ProShares and Valkyrie, the action appears to have opened the door for an immediate path to a physically settled Bitcoin ETF coming to the market. And founder and CEO of digital currency group Barry Silbert had Grayscale's application for a spot ETF waiting on his back pocket for the SEC to allow Grayscale competitors to enter the market. And quoting CNBC right here, the investment firm had intended to file its application to the Securities and Exchange Commission as soon as the agency allowed efforts by competitors for futures-based Bitcoin ETF, said the person. That happened late. On Friday, the approval of Bitcoin ETF products enables a more competitive landscape and also unlocks new pools of capital from different pockets of traditional financial institutions that were previously facing too many hurdles to get exposure to the king of all crypto. So how exactly is a Bitcoin spot ETF different? Well, a spot ETF product tracks the Bitcoin price closer than a futures ETF. The spot price of Bitcoin is the current USD cost for immediate purchase and delivery. Being physically settled with instant delivery, a spot product would be able to more closely track the price of Bitcoin and reduce uncertainty that comes with an ETF tracking a projected future price. And quoting Anthony Pompliano of Morgan Creek Digital here, a Bitcoin spot ETF would be better for investors, both from a price tracking and fee structure standpoint. And if approved, the timing for Grayscale spot ETF comes at an intriguing moment in the market, right during the height of this bull market. Let's freaking go. Bitcoin continues to push over 60,000 USD and is eyeing previous all-time high prices, all while fresh off a Bitcoin mining ban in China, and U.S. politicians continuing to signal support for the nascent digital asset. So there you have it. And before I break down our final story of the day, Bitcoin entering the final stage of a major bull trend, according to this crypto analyst who foresees Bitcoin surpassing $100,000 in the next few months, as well as his bullish price prediction of Bitcoin surging 900% here in Q4, taking us to $370,000 per BTC. But first, I want to remind you to smash that show more button right below this video in the description for a detailed analysis of what's going on in the crypto market. This goes for all 940 plus videos right here on my YouTube channel. Also, some very helpful resources for you to plug into, including my daily letter, which goes out to over 30,000 subscribers every single day. To subscribe, visit letter.cryptonewsalerts.net. Also, a blog I update daily, which could be found at cryptonewsyes.com. Also, be sure to smash that subscribe button and ring that bell to help me get to 50,000 subs. And of course, you can follow me on all the major podcasting platforms, from Spotify, home of the Joe Rogan Experience, to Apple's iTunes and Google Play. You can follow me on Twitter. My Twitter handle is Crypto News Yes. And of course, you can follow me on TikTok, Telegram, and Facebook. So be sure to follow me there. But all right, now let's break down our final story of the day. Trader and crypto analyst Alessio Rastani believes Bitcoin is entering the final stage of the current bull market, which will propel the leading crypto to $100,000 price target. And to explain his prediction, he cited the Elliott wave theory, which divides upward price trends into five waves. Rastani believes we have entered the final wave of the bull trend that started at the beginning of 2019 and should see its top at some point next year. Quoting him here, when this five-way move completes, then I'm expecting a bear market. And here's the basic Elliott wave theory. Market prices subdivide into five waves when they're going in the direction of the larger trend, and they subdivide into three waves when they're going against the larger trend. And citing research by behavioral finance expert Jason Jaupfert, Rastani predicted that the next Bitcoin bear market may coincide with a broader downtrend in traditional markets, which could come in the next couple of years. Rastani pointed out that Bitcoin would be negatively affected by a stock market correction, given that both stocks and BTC are risk on assets. Quoting him here, when there is an appetite for risk, both markets go up. But when there's low appetite, when there's little appetite for risk, they go down. So there you have it. Let me know if you agree or disagree with this crypto analyst. And do you feel $100,000 Bitcoin price is likely in the following months here of Q4? Holla at your boy. Now checking out the latest from crypto analyst TechDev. He wrote, diving further into the biweekly RSI channel, we see Bitcoin had a very significant break. Both times it bounced off to 1.272. It then broke the RSI channel EQ. This led to a 900% pump in 2013 and 2017. 900% in 2021 gives us a 370,000 $1,000 BTC, he also goes on to share, unlikely in my opinion, but a massive move is coming. And he shares this chart, which compares the bull cycles of 2013, 2017 to that of 2021. And checking out his other tweet, Bitcoin will exit the yellow circle before you know it, especially if history repeats or even rhymes. Check it out, 2013 and 2017, the market went absolutely parabolic right at the time we're currently at. So expect fireworks here in Q4. He also shares this chart, which shows a $200,000 to $300,000 Bitcoin looks almost to program. That's right. And now for a quick recap of what I covered with you here in today's show. Bitcoin price eyes all-time high weekly close above 60,000 ahead of Bitcoin ETF turbulence. I also shared that Salvadorans are now selling way more US dollars to buy Bitcoin, as well as breaking news. Grayscale Investments plans to file for a spot Bitcoin ETF early next week, according to reports by CNBC. Also in today's show, we discussed Bitcoin entering the final stage of a major bull trend, according to this crypto analyst who foresees Bitcoin surpassing $100,000 in the next few months. Also shared this chart, which shows a potential 900% pump here in Q4 for the king of all crypto, which could take us to a $370,000 Bitcoin price. But where do you feel the Bitcoin price is likely to go next? Let me know in the comments right down below. I want to give a quick shout out to Helen and No Money G, who wrote BTC to $100,000 and JV to 50,000 subs soon. I appreciate the contributions as always, fam. Now for the top three comments from yesterday's episode. Super Geek Toys wrote another amazing video by my man JV. Every day is a wild ride right now. I love that your insights keep my head in the right place and not wanting to just go crazy with overbuying. Make a plan, work the plan. We got this, fam. Let's freaking go. And my response, cheers, crypto fam. Much love. I appreciate your continued support. Q4 BTC, moon time. Let's freaking go. And our next featured comment comes from G. Dean, who wrote, JV, love your show. I believe we can hit $250,000 for BTC this cycle. However, I am disappointed with the ETFs. Physical BTC is the real ETF, in my opinion, but I guess we need to crawl before we walk. Facts, fam, I agree with you 100%. Let's go. And our third and final featured comment of the day comes from Doug, who wrote, this new ETF looks more like price control vehicle for the Fed and big banks than a way for the public to be exposed to the price change in BTC. My response, yep, you're right, fam. It's the physical backed Bitcoin ETF, which will be the true game changer. Stay tuned. And to be featured on tomorrow's episode, drop me a comment right down below. Well, that's going to conclude today's show. As always, I appreciate you tuning in and journeying along with me inside this incredible crypto matrix. That's right, Bitcoin is the glitch in the matrix. If you gained value out of today's show, be sure to smash that subscribe button and ring that bell to turn on all notifications to receive daily premium crypto news alerts every single day, including weekends, just like this. And I look forward to seeing you on tomorrow's episode. Peace.